I'm really thrilled to be introducing you to a young social entrepreneur, Lauren Bush. Lauren is the founder and CEO of an organization, a company, a social enterprise called Feed, which has a very simple aim. What her company does is it produces products that help to feed the world. And for example, Lauren has a bag made of organic hessian, and one bag helps to feed one child in the developing world for 1 year. Incredible achievement. Lauren is a graduate of Princeton University in the US. She's Denver born. She's long been involved in issues surrounding food programs. She was an honorary spokesperson for the United Nations World Food Program. And since 2004, she helped launch its University's Fighting Hunger Initiative, which engages university-age students in the fight against world hunger. So it's my pleasure to introduce Lauren Bush.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, hello. That was a tough act to follow, so I will do my best. Thank you so much for the introduction and for having me here to lend my voice in this discussion about global business. Let me move my mic up just a little bit. As we gather here at the One Young World Conference, I am so inspired and so energized to see our peers not only taking interest in all these global issues, but really taking action. The beauty of our world today is that we are so interconnected. There's no longer an excuse for ignorance or turning a blind eye. Once we see something that is wrong or people that are suffering, we can do nothing less than take action. And that is why, as the torch is slowly passed in the business world to our generation, I believe that we will approach things differently than those who have come before us. The importance of doing good in business will be just as important as doing well in business. Social missions will be at the core of our business mission statements, not just written in as part of the corporate social responsibility. Just as one of my personal heroes, Muhammad Yunus, spoke to earlier today, the new model of social business is one based on doing good for the world, not making profit. Social business runs on its own steam. It has an endless life, he said. My social business, Feed Project, started 3 years ago with the mission to make good products that feed the world. It started with one reusable bag, which I happen to have here, made of organic cotton and burlap, and with the one printed on one side and the brand Feed printed on the other, with each bag being sold to feed one child in school for 1 year. My journey to Feed started when I was introduced to the work of the UN World Food Program. When I was a sophomore in college, they're the largest humanitarian agency in the world, feeding over 100 million people per year. My role as an honorary spokesperson took me on a journey around the world to see their operations firsthand. The program that I was most touched by was their school feeding program, which operates in 74 countries around the world, feeding the poorest kids. This program is brilliant because not only does it guarantee that these kids will get a nutritious meal a day, but it is often the reason these kids go to school in the first place and why their parents send them to school. Thus, it is promoting education while obviously encouraging nutrition as well. I was so touched on one of my trips, I met a little girl in Kenya who ate half of her porridge ravenously and then balled up the other half and stuck it in her pocket to take home, I assume, to one of her younger siblings who wasn't at school that day. So it really showed me how important the school meal really is. It's vital. These kids really rely on it, and their parents do as well. So it is through my travels that I've really interacted with hunger, world hunger. And the sad fact is that 1 billion people are hungry in this world. And every 6 seconds, just while I'm talking, a child dies of hunger. So that fact alone was something I just could not live with. I'd come back from my trips inspired but also frustrated. The problem of hunger seemed so out of reach to people in America that I was talking to, so overwhelming. So how could I break it down for people, especially young people, who wanted to take action, wanted to do something, but just did not know what to do? That is where the idea of the feed bag came. I love design. I'd interacted in the fashion world, and I knew I could do something by using my talents and passions to hopefully not only make a difference and feed kids, but also make this issue really accessible for people, for my peers. So I designed the initial feed bag to look like the bags of grain and other food rations I saw being distributed by the World Food Program. And there feed grew. Feed moved very quickly beyond the first bag into many bags, and now teddy bears and bracelets. But each one has a very clear, tangible number attached to it, which signifies a donation. So you know exactly what you're doing by buying each product. It's not a percentage of profits. It's not a percentage of sales or proceeds. It's a very clear, tangible donation to a very clear organization. And to date, for the 3 years we've been operating, we've been able to sell enough bags to feed 50 million kids just through this one little bag idea. So. Thank you. So we've been so proud of that, and I would love just to share that with you only in that I think it's an example of what a very small, a very simple idea, as Muhammad Yunus said today, to start to affect one person's life with one simple idea and then let it grow from there. So now we have a Feed Foundation as well to address the fact that not only 1 billion people are hungry in this world, but 1 billion people are obese. So the dichotomy, our food system is really a huge issue that we need to address, and our foundation is doing just that. I will end by saying that I would encourage everyone here, just as Muhammad Yunus did so eloquently earlier, to use your individual and collective passions, intellect, and talents to tackle the pressing issues of hunger and all the other issues that our world faces through a social business platform. There are so many who will not understand your vision, but you must press on. We are the ones who will inherit the world, and it is our duty to care for the earth and the people living in it the best we can. The challenge of businesses today is to make it easy and meaningful for customers, consumers, and clients to do good. And this is the challenge I propose to you all today. Thank you.